A little sweaty. I'm pretty sure this is part two of the intake scoop funneling. Ducting. Maybe ducting is a little better because it's not... Yeah, we'll call it ducting. I can't remember what I said last time, which was 2 days ago, I think. That's bad. Okay, so I'm getting the iron warmed up. I already got the hole trimmed out. I got the pieces all cut out. I think that's what it was. It was basically getting the pieces cut out. Yep. So I'm at the point where I'm pretty sure I said I was gonna be. Okay, so this is basically what I came up with. I don't know if I showed much of it last time. It might have been glued on there. But I got the pieces cut out. But yeah, might as well get to it. And yeah. So, progress is I got things started to be mounted. Things line up where they currently are right now. So, what I'm going to do is I am going to finish this. But I have to wait for, I can't remember what it's exactly called, but it's basically that aluminum foil type, tape, So basically, the concept is you want to, as the, how do I want to say it? The forced in air, or the air going in, you want it as cool as possible. You don't want to be leaving, you know, as in through the material, or, which is the bigger problem, is heat getting in and heat soaking the material, and it's heating up the air as it's going in. So the main factor, or the main goal, is to keep heat from getting in to the intake system by the material where it's being fed into. So when that tape comes, the feed will get it, because it's basically right above one of the hotter pieces, the turbo. This scoop will get it. The air box will get it. I gotta take it apart, obviously, to do it, because I don't know if you've guys seen how the intake is. You can basically, if you go to K&N website, or I guess anywhere where, you know, kind of K&N distributor, and they have basically this air box that you can get, that's a universal air box, but it came with the kit from Ural Compulsion. So, you know, that was part of it. But when I was looking up replacement filters, I found out, hey, you can get that air box universal. So, yeah, you know, you can go to K&N's website. It's probably the best. And I think maybe just look up universal air boxes. It's just a basic air cone. Not too terribly big. I think it's like roughly, you know, probably more than 6 wide at the widest part, and it goes down to about 4 maybe, and I think it's about 4 tall, if not a little more. I can't remember what comes with that kit, but I know you can get this separate, and you can honestly make your own tubing setup however you please. But yeah, I'm going to, because I got these mounted, I just got to drill the holes, get that mounted, throw another strap on there, reinforce, the corner, or the, around the corner as well. I'm trying to think how I can, I might throw a piece that goes over here as well. I think I'll leave. I probably should have put one here instead of one here. But what I'll probably do is add another strap that comes, routes over and attaches here. I ain't thinking about it. So it doesn't twist back on itself, and I gotta reinforce the backside so it's stiffer, and it, you know, more, it most likely won't try to do that stiff, and stay still. But yeah, just actually a long update apparently. But yeah, next time I come back be the end of the video, and it'll, everything should be wrapped in foil. It should be, for me, by the end of the week. Hopefully, it comes. It might actually, no, I think that's coming Friday. So, that's coming Friday. The aluminum foil tape, or duct tape, or ducting tape. But yeah, I'll get back to you in a second. Oh, good morning, good morning, good morning. It's the end of the video of part 2 of the intake ducting video. It's more or less what it is. I made, before I show you the finish, installed, all that, I rerouted
if you can see it in there, I don't know if you can, well, you can see the shiny tape, but there's also a, oh, I still have it over there, the same stuff as I have, if you can see it, I think, yep, the same, the grill metal mesh, wow, the same mesh material as I used for the scoop, and I used, yeah, rerouted it. I used like I don't know if I showed it in this video, but another video or whatever, the Lockline, it was like an orange piece that I had, like a cone funnel. I'm pretty sure I did earlier in this video, or part one, if you didn't watch that. And to go back, because I think I might have explained it in part one, is real quick that I had, excuse me, the tubing routed, so it was kind of on the side of the ducting for directing air for the radiator intercooler. That's it. Okay. Focused on that, and I basically created a piece, or the same piece that mounts for the intake feed up top, bolted that on there and had it shooting in there. But really, really thinking about it now, air is not really nicely getting in that way. It's nice and protected. You don't get really crappy material getting in there, but it wasn't getting the air without it running and without knowing the information sensors and whatnot, that I wasn't getting the air that I really, really wanted. So I ended up rerouting it to where I had it originally, is I put it in the fog light section and threw a mesh piece in, so no large pieces get in there. I mean, it's still got to go up and around, but hey, crazy things happen. I'd rather be safe than sorry. Okay, get to the point of the end of the video of showing you the finished product with it all taped up. Now, there we be. And I don't know if I can show. Maybe. Low bar. Yeah, I got a little bit. But right now, this is all set. Everything's bolted, clamped, up. And hoses are on that were taken off before, I believe. It's taped up for protecting the air going in to the system, so it doesn't get heat soaked and unnecessary heat from the engine bay, which is big because, I mean, you got a giant heat producing piece right there, you know. Obviously, you got the radiator right next door too, you know. So, and then coolant lines really, really close in the area. Eventually I'll have to do something about maybe making my own intake tube and doing a really, really custom. I would really like to do like a 3D printed setup. Somehow, some way, a company would do it. do the same thing, you know, I'm doing. But, you know, I'm not against this, the angle of the pipe. If you can see it, it kind of goes somewhat straight and then juts up. Preferably, I'd rather have that pipe straight as possible, and I'd like to shove, even though there's radiator lines in the way, or like right there, and it wraps around and it goes, if you can see it down there, that little really dark looking hose right there, it wraps around with that, and I ended up throwing some heat shielding on the tube. Where do I have it? If you can see it over there. Yeah, right there. That's the tubing that's connecting in to the fog light area. So I wrapped some of this foil tape on it. again, re-explanation, the reason I did that. I also wrapped it in the scoop as well. The bottom side of it is basically, you know, I've been on a binge, I guess, of watching Banks Power, Gale Banks, and all that, and all the information he has and knowledge, and you know, I always knew, you know, from, you know, really getting in it, is heat can be your biggest enemy, the biggest problem, the biggest destroyer of engines, destroyer of parts, the biggest problem. Everybody says, oh, this and that and yada yada. No, heat, I mean, maybe not. Maybe people are actually smart, but the biggest problem is heat. How to control heat, not control it, but because you can't, you know, you can't create or destroy energy, as in usually energies known as heat energy. So you can't, you know, an engine is the biggest potential energy device, or we'll go with device, that at still has a very great ability for potential energy, and as it starts up, and you know, the process of the internal combustion engine, and then trying to transfer the heat to the radiator system, and then out, and then trying to get the heat from the radiator out, and then the intercooler out, you know, heat everywhere. So the idea is, I don't want heat going, unnecessary heat going into the engine through the intake system. I know, you know, a freaking radiator line right there defeats the point, but I think what I'm gonna do is probably throw one of these heat wrappings around it for tubing. I want to say I have some more around, or I could probably just throw some tape around it, but I really would rather have that whole thing wrapped in that tape, and you know, so nothing's going in there. All the coolest air I can is shoved in there. The cooler it is, the more dense it is, the more air molecules go in the engine, the more power you make, the more efficiency you make, the less problems happen, the less heat hurting performance. So that is the goal with why, you know, I did the foil, is to not, you know, again, it might not be a ton, but it might be more than I know. I you know, I eventually want to get sensors and stuff like that in places so I know where I can either improve or, you know where there's a problem, but mainly improve and know information while I'm racing. I got it set up and, hey, something's off. Bleep, bleep, or not, you know, not a bleep, but, you know, a color goes on that parameter. I think that's what it is. That information spot, you know. But that's, you know, that's down the road, you know. I don't have an endless amount of money like other people that waste it. So, yeah, but when I get to that point, I already got a Banks, I-dash gauge, that's what I'm looking for, I-dash gauge, and I'm gonna reposition the switches buttons, and redo that dash piece that I have, if you guys watch my other videos, and move the switches down on the towards the front of the engine in the cab or the cockpit or compartment, interior compartment, whatever. Just in front of the handbrake, and kind of have the switches there for, you know, late bar hazards. What else do I have? Couple other things, you know, interior lights I got going on. A couple other things I can't think of. Keep the window switches in the same spot because they're out of the way, but throw the the gauges kind of in those areas that, you know, where the switches used to be. So they're right there, and have the ability for, they have a Hall effect sensor, I believe it is. Or yeah, that can go on your, the flywheel. I can't think of the name, but you know, if you look at, not your flywheel. Your, you know, in your area of your front crank pulley, there's a wheel. I can't think of the name of the wheel. That has like little, like square juts all around it that I guess captures or takes, you know, as the crank spinning, that, you know, RPM and, you know, things like that, and put that on there. No RPM. Have a shift, you know, have a shift light tell me when to shift, you know, when I, you know, should be shifting. But this part is way long than I wanted. But finished product again, and you know, this is the end of part two, and I don't know what's next. Neither do you. So, you know, it is what it is. You know, I got some new welding rod. Where did I get this from? Wow, blank. welding store, right? Welding. Welding store.com. And a little thing is, I really like a little logo. I don't know if it's just this brand. It's probably just this brand, but I guess I didn't know at the time. Their little logo is a little blue devil. And little fun fact is, I played football and ran track at a school called Ogdensburg Free Academy, and played football, at least in the city, for 12 years from first grade to a day I graduated, and track a period of time, and their mascot was the Blue Devil, so I thought that was kind of funny and cool how their logo is like a welding Blue Devil. So that's whatever. That's the point, or whatever point it is. But yeah, be hitting it hard on the skid plate, getting that done, because that's a time consuming thing. to a point. What else? Yeah, I got my oil pan. I don't know if I showed that another time. but yeah, in a video, I'm gonna make sure you guys see what's going on with that. I really got to get the plating done. There's a lot of stuff that's, you know, I almost want to say the next video will in reality, me driving this, because I got some metal working done, redid that centerpiece with the kill switch, put the fire suppression system pole in it, got the lock for the handbrake, because it's required for ARA to have a quote-unquote working parking brake. So, you know, I did that. And I have to do a little welding on the corners to strengthen that part. but yeah, progress is kind of being made. So thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, and see you in the next video.